Suppose if I have theta, theta if it is an angle, then the multiples angles are nothing but 2 theta, 3 theta, 4 theta and so on are the multiples of this angle theta. Is it right? Usually we know the definition of multiple. With the same idea, if theta is an angle, then its multiples like 2 theta, 3 theta, 4 theta all will represent the multiples of that angle theta. And now I need to generate formulas for these multiple angles, and in particularly we concentrate on 2 theta, that's enough. Okay, then our first point of today's class related to the multiple angles is generating the rule for sine 2 theta, right? Sine 2 theta. See, I have sine theta. Then what you say about sine 2 theta? If the angle is known for us, then it is very easy. 2 theta we will calculate, sine 2 theta we will give you. If we have an unknown angle theta, then we need to express sine 2 theta in terms of again sine theta and cos theta. I will give you formulas first, and then if possible I will do certain simple problems also. Sine 2 theta, look there here. See, this is equals to sine of 2 theta, right? I can write the 2 theta as theta plus theta. Is there anything wrong? Nothing wrong, look there. See, sine of theta plus theta. See, if you treat this as A and this as B, sine of theta plus theta can be written as sine A cos B. See, for suppose if you feel any discomfort there, you just mark them as A and B, nothing will happen, right? Sine 2 theta, sine of theta plus theta, okay? You just treat this first theta as some A and second theta as B, both are A and B only. And sine of that A plus B is equals to, I have the formula that sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Is it right? And now here, A is theta, B is theta, A and B both are theta. Replace A and B with theta, sine theta into cos theta, again, cos theta into sine theta. Now at the end, if you look, sine theta into cos theta and cos theta into sine theta both are same. So I can write it like 2 sine theta cos theta. So at the end, sine 2 theta is just 2 sine theta cos theta. So this is the formula for sine 2 theta. Is it right? Similarly, we can take A and B with the theta in cos of A plus B and tan of A plus B. There you will get the formulas for cos 2 theta and tan. Yeah. First of all, if you look there, cos of 2 theta. See, cos of 2 theta can be written as of cos of theta plus theta. See, now this is A and this is B. So A is theta, B is also theta. But cos of A plus B, I know cos A cos B. So I can write it like cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. I think it is very clear, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Cos A cos B, both are theta, right? Cos square theta minus sin square theta. So sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. Whereas cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. In a similar fashion, if you try, you have a chance to write tan 2 theta. Yeah, you just try to simplify tan 2 theta. See, tan of A plus B, A is theta, B is theta here. See, tan of A plus B is tan A plus tan B, right? The same way if you think tan theta plus tan theta divided by 1 minus tan theta into tan theta. If you replace A and B with the theta in tan of A plus B. On simplification, the numerator is 2 tan theta and the denominator is 1 minus tan square theta. Just have a look completely. Sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. Cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. Whereas tan 2 theta is 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. Have a look once. Just have a look, sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta, cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta, and tan 2 theta is 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. So for suppose if I have cos 2 theta as cos square theta minus sin square theta, I can rewrite it, okay, in different formats. See, in first format, I convert everything in terms of sin. The second format, I convert everything in terms of cos. So for that, what will happen? Here I do like this, yeah, cos 2 theta is equals to cos square theta minus sin square theta is there here, okay, and I will write that sin square theta again 1 minus cos square theta. Just look there. I am converting cos 2 theta completely in terms of cos. Cos 2 theta is equals to cos square theta minus 1 minus cos square theta. So further on simplification, cos 2 theta is equals to minus of minus is plus, cos square theta plus cos square theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. Cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. So send 1 this side, you will get that cos 2 theta plus 1 is equals to 2 cos square theta. See, cos 2 theta plus 1 is 2 cos square theta, and cos theta is equals to, or cos square theta is equals to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. And now if you need cos theta, we need to use plus or minus. Cos theta is equals to plus or minus root of 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So this is something about relation between cos 2 theta and cos theta. In a similar way, if you now convert everything in terms of sign, so now again I will start, cos 2 theta is equals to cos square theta minus sin square theta. Now you just rewrite this cos square theta as 1 minus sin square. So 1 minus sin square theta minus sin square theta. So in the next step, what will happen? Cos 2 theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta minus sin square theta, 1 minus 2 sin square theta. Just like this. Now, what to say about 2 sin square theta? 2 sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta. And sin square theta I will write as 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. And at the end, sin theta. Since we are sending square that side, you will get plus or minus. Sin theta is equals to plus or minus root of 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Just have a look. Here cos theta is root of 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Here sin theta is root of 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. See, both looks like same and both are very useful, okay? Once you look there, cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. That's what you need to utilize. Cos 2 theta is equals to 2 cos square theta minus 1. See, this is also useful. Cos 2 theta is equals to 1 minus 2 sin square theta. You need to memorize it. And at the end, cos theta is equals to plus or minus root of 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Here plus or minus root of 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. These three as well as those three you need to memorize to solve different problems. Okay. And here you need to think once, plus or minus is there. What we need to use? Either plus or minus. See, sometimes we use plus sign and sometimes we use minus sign. That's all depending on the value of theta. That's all depending on the value of theta. If theta is an angle which gives you positive result, use plus sign. If theta is an angle which gives you negative result, then use minus sign. That's it actually. So cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. This can be split in two ways, and these two discussions are much useful. And at the end, there is one more chance here. See, cos theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Sin theta is 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. From there, if you utilize these two, sin and cos, from there is a chance to write tan theta. Is it right? Then that tan theta is equals to square root of sin by cos wrong. That's why 1 minus cos 2 theta by 1 plus cos 2 theta will be the tan if cos 2 theta is known. Just memorize this. If cos 2 theta is known, then easily we can write sin theta, cos theta as well as tan theta using these formulas. Just have a look once. Yeah. If cos 2 theta is given for us, to calculate sin, cos and tan, directly we use these formulas, right? I will give you some simple problems on this, okay? Right. See, these are the formulas with us, and that is the problem. Cos 2 theta is given as 12 by 13, and we need to find sin 2 theta, sin theta, cos theta and tan theta. See, very simple task. One by one you need to use the formulas. 2 theta and 2 theta. Angles are same here. So, this is the formula. Sin 2 theta is, this is okay, right? In terms of theta and theta. But sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is always 1, right? So, sin square 2 theta and cos square 2 theta. Angle is same. That's why sin square 2 theta plus cos square 2 theta is equals to again 1. If you need, use it to find sin 2 theta. Cos 2 theta value I have. So, just replace cos 2 theta with 12 by 13. From there, directly you will get. Okay? Is it clear? I think so. Yeah, this is the one of the way. Or otherwise, cos 2 theta is given as 12 by 13. So, if you construct a right angle triangle for 2 theta. See, look there. Cos 2 theta is equals to 12 by 13. See, think about the angle. The angle is 2 theta. So, if you construct a right angle triangle with the angle 2 theta, cos is the adjacent side with hypotenuse, but we don't know opposite side. See, using Pythagorean result, if you find that opposite side, see, question mark square plus 12 square is equals to 13 square. From there, you will find that question mark value is 5. Since question mark value is 5, it is very clear that sine 2 theta is opposite side by hypotenuse, and that is 5 by 13. So, sine 2 theta value is 5 by 13, and that's completed using this triangle. And now we need to find what? Sin theta, cos theta and tan theta. Just think, okay? Usually in the objective questions you may ask you, see, the question may ask you to find any one of the value. Sin 2 theta or sin theta or cos theta or tan theta, not all the four at a time, okay? See, if they ask us to find sin 2 theta with cos 2 theta, you just go with this procedure. Use cos 2 theta, find sin 2 theta, there is the task. Whereas, if they won't ask you to find sin 2 theta, cos theta is given, cos 2 theta, right? Cos 2 theta is given and they ask you to find sin theta. How to find? See, at the end I will give you the formula. Sin theta is how much? Sin theta is equals to square root of 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Very direct formula. You just replace this cos 2 theta with 12 by 13, that's enough. See, if the quadrant is quadrant of theta, the range of theta is not mentioned, you just go with the plus sign, no problem. So, this is equals to square root of 1 minus, this is 12 by 13 divided by 2. If you took LCM, 13 minus 12 is 1, and on simplification you will get it as how much? Yeah, 13 minus 12 is 1, 1 by root 26. This is sin theta. In the similar way, if you do cos theta, yeah, we have the rule, right? Cos 2 theta is equals to what? Square root of 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. See, cos 2 theta is 12 by 13, replace here, and on simplification I think you may get it as, yeah, cos 2 theta is what? 12 by 13, 13 plus 12 is what? 25 by 26, so 5 by root 26, okay? And you may write it like this, 1 by root 26 also, because square root of 1 is 1, right? So sin theta is 1 by root 26, cos theta is 5 by root 26, and if you divide sin theta with cos theta, you will get that tan theta is equals to 1 by 5. There is the problem actually. So, if cos 2 theta is known for us like 12 by 13, then there is a chance to find sin 2 theta, sin theta, cos theta and tan theta using these wonderful results. Have a look. Just think about the formulas, okay? Sin 22 out of degree sine. Yeah, we have this formula from the left side. See, sin theta is equals to square root of, okay, and then take theta is equals to 22 and half. See, theta is equals to 22 and half, what will happen? Sin theta, that theta is 22 and half, so sin of 22 and half is equals to square root of 1 minus cos 2 theta. Yeah. Now just think about it. Double of 22 and half. Theta is 22 and half. 2 theta is 2 into 22 and half, which is just nothing but 45 degrees divided by 2. And now you need to use what? Cos 45 degrees value, which is 1 by root 2. So this is equals to 1 minus 1 by root 2 divided by 2. Took LCM in the numerator. And then simplify. Root 2 minus 1 by 2 root 2. This is equals to square root of root 2 minus 1 by 2 root 2. Just have it. Then sine 22 and of degrees is square root of root 2 minus 1 by 2 root 2. Since for sine theta, root of 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So minus sign is there. 1 minus cos 45, root 2 minus 1 by 2 root 2. So similarly, if you go with the for cos 22 and of. Similarly, if you go for cos 22 and of, cos theta is here you get 1 plus. That's why cos theta, you may get it as root of root 2 plus 1 by 2 root. Just have a look once. Sin theta is what? Root of root 2 minus 1 by 2 root 2. Similarly, if you go, cos theta is what? Root of root 2 plus 1 by 2 root 2. And now what you say about tan 22 and of? I will erase it, okay? And now, think about tan 22 and of degrees. Yeah. Tan 22 and of degrees is equals to actually sine by cos, okay? Yeah. Sine 22 and of divided by cos 22 and of. And that is equals to sine value is this root of root 2 minus 1 by 2 root 2. Cos value is this root of root 2 plus 1 by 2 root 2. This denominator is 2 root 2. Here the denominator is 2 root 2. If you divide, denominator will get cancelled. You left with the root of root 2 minus 1. Yeah. Numerator of sine divided by root 2 plus 1. This numerator of cos as denominator for tan. Further, we need to simplify by multiplying with the root 2 minus 1 numerator and denominator. This is equals to root of root 2 minus 1 divided by root 2 plus 1 into root 2 minus 1 divided by root 2 plus 1. Now you need to think a while here, okay? See, the denominator is what? Root 2 plus 1 into root 2 minus 1, right? I multiplied with root 2 minus 1, both numerator and denominator. And now if you multiply this root 2 minus 1 into root 2 plus 1, a plus b into a minus b format, it gives us 1 only. And in the numerator, there are 2 root 2 minus 1s, okay? So this can be written as root of root 2 minus 1 whole square by 1. On simplification, you get it as root 2 minus 1. Very simple task, okay? Tan 22 and of degrees value is how much? Root 2 minus 1. Whereas sine 22 and of and cos 22 and of are somewhat different. Just have a look. The values are related to the 22 and of degrees. So, just now we derived the values of sine 22 and of, cos 22 and of, tan 22 and of. Using all those values, we need to write these answers, right? Sine 67 and of. You just think about this angle. And you just think about this angle, 22 and of. See, first of all, you need to observe that 67 and of degrees plus 22 and of degrees is equals to 90 degrees. This is what you need to keep in your brains. See, if sum of two angles is 90 degrees, then sine alpha is equals to cos beta. We discussed it in different cases, in many ways, okay? Sine 67 and of degrees is just equal to the cos 22 and of degrees, and its value is this. Cos 67 and of degrees is just equal to the sine 22 and of degrees, and its value is this. Whereas, cot 22 and of. See, tan 22 and of is there here, and I am asking you about cot 22 and of. See, cot is just the reciprocal of tan, so this is 1 by root 2 minus 1. And further, again if you multiply both with root 2 plus 1 numerator and denominator, this 1 by root 2 minus 1 is just equal to the root 2 plus 1, both are same. That's what you need to identify. And now, tan 67 and of. Tan 67 and of, this is 67 and of. See, 67 and of plus 22 and of is 90 degrees. So tan of one angle is equal to the cot of other. So this is equal to cot 22 and of. And now this value is what? Root 2 plus 1. Just think a while. See, if sum of two angles is 90 degrees, sine of one angle is the cos of other. Cos of one angle is the sine of other. Tan of one angle is the cot of other. With that idea, I have a chance to write all these values. Just have a look and go with a screenshot. tan 2 theta is 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. See, think this angle, okay? For something, what I am going to write is tan 2 theta is equals to 2t by 1 minus t square. Okay? See, be cautious about these things. This is tan theta, this is tan 2 theta. Tan theta is different from tan 2 theta. Don't treat tan 2 theta as 2 tan theta. Everybody, okay? Maybe some people will there. They get confused, okay? Tan 2 theta is equals to 2 tan 2 tan theta, they will feel. This is a wrong statement. Tan 2 theta is this 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. Yeah, tan 2 theta is 2t by 1 plus t square. T is equal to tan theta. And now take a triangle. This angle is 2 theta. Tan is opposite by adjacent. Take this side is 2 theta. This side is 1 minus t square. And we need to find this hypotenuse, which will be the square root of the sum of the squares of these two. 2t whole square plus 1 minus t square whole square. Further we need to simplify. See, further if you try to simplify it, this is equals to square root of 4t square plus 1 minus t square whole square. 1 minus 2t square plus t power 4. And you just simplify it like this. Square root of t power 4. 4t square minus 2t square is 2t square plus 1. And now this is equals to square root of t square plus 1 whole square. Now square and root will get cancelled. You will have to with the t square plus 1. Very important identification this. If tan 2 theta is equals to 2t by 1 plus 1 minus t square. This side is 2t, this side is 1 minus t square. And we are going to find it. And that will become like t square plus 1. So now we have all the three sides of the right angle triangle where one angle is 2 theta. So with that, I can write sin 2 theta now. Yeah, sin 2 theta. And in the same manner, cos 2 theta. See, sin 2 theta is opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite is 2t, hypotenuse is 1 plus t square. Cos 2 theta is adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent is 1 minus t square, hypotenuse is 1 plus t square. Yeah, but what is t actually? See, just I treated this tan theta as t. So if we replace tan t with t, tan theta, you will get it is equals to 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. And this is equals to 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. So this is cos 2 theta, this is sin 2 theta, whereas this is tan 2 theta. So if tan theta is known for us, we can calculate tan 2 theta, sin 2 theta, cos 2 theta using these formulas. And then you need to memorize this tan 2 theta formula, this sin 2 theta and this cos 2 theta. Just have a look.